Jackie Robinson first set foot on Tanker Field before a crowd of 6,550. Three quarters of the fans were African American. They came to see Jackie Robinson. The Negro bleachers were filled early. So about 2,500 fans were sitting along the grassy foul lines and all around the outfield. They wanted to see Jackie Robinson and Ray Campanella. This is the time of month, right now in March, that we should be celebrating or proclaiming March 17, 2015 as Jackie Robinson Day in the city of Orlando. But yet, we won't have a venue to do that because we will tear it down. Ted Haddock also points out Jackie Robinson had an all-star team of black baseball players that played the Orlando All-Stars, black baseball players. A young Napoleon Ford, Charles Pelham, and Lefty Richards. The Orlando All-Stars team was organized by Felix Kozma, who was my principal when I went to Washington Shores Elementary School from first grade to half of my sixth grade. Ford recalls standing in awe that he was standing on the same field as Robinson. And Ford said, he was bigger than life, a great man. It took a great man to do what he did. He took so much abuse. He kept turning the other cheek, even when there was no other cheek. And then Ford also said, because they had to play at Cotter Street Park. As Nat Ford put it, the ballparks, and that's Cotter Street Park and Tinker Field, were a 10-minute walk apart. 10 minutes, 1,000 miles, and 1,000 years. There are opportunities for even some of our local people to play baseball. Dr. Tom Withers has a baseball team and he wants to play at Tinker Field, but he can't get through the door. Rob Sight with the Florida Collegiate Summer League, he wants to bring some college players in to play at Tinker Field. He can't get through the door. Ricky Weeks and the Monarch, a black baseball team, young people that would also love to call Tinker Field home. But they can't get through the door. Now this is Orlando. They should be able to get through the door because we are a progressive city and we're supposed to be an inclusive city. We're supposed to set the standard for the nation. And I would say to all of my commissioners on this board that we need to set the standard. We need to do the right thing. We need to invest in the black community. What's $10 million when we have spent over $1 billion on all of our venues? We have made a difference. And Commissioner Ortiz, you remember that Azalea Park, Clemente is back because somebody destroyed the picture. But yet the community rose up and the artist decided that he would restore that picture of Roberto Clemente. And it meant a lot. And all I'm saying to my city commissioners, and also to the mayor, look, let us proceed to take care of Tinker Field. Do not let us needlessly tear down a historic treasure, an icon within our city. Tinker Field represents tearing down the walls of segregation and establishing a field of inclusion for all races of people. And, you know, I just cannot really fathom us pushing the electric daisy. If we push the electric daisy, is this the kind of image we want to portray in our community? And get this, the electric daisy is not provide any economic development for us. It's all about them. Well, I would say this, Mayor, and I would would say this council. Now's the time for all of your people to come together and do some great things for America. We should be looking at ways of making this thing happen in our community. Even the Orange Democrats, thank you, Carlos Smith, and Secretary Patricia Ruff, who signed the resolution. Thank you, because you are saying that the city of Orlando.